So, as already been discussed by all the speakers earlier, that obviously using how to know and how to use an operating microscope is the basics which a person who's joining a post as a postgraduate trainee in ophthalmology has to know. Since it is the most important surgical instrument in the era of ophthalmic surgeries, most of the ophthalmic surgeries we are using a microscope. It provides us not only with a magnified view and illuminated high-quality image of the miniature structures of our eye, but also it has an additional benefit of giving us a high quality of stereopsis, which is actually required for all our surgical procedures. So understanding the settings of your microscope is therefore the most important fundamental step of an ophthalmic surgery. What are the prerequisites for an ideal microscope? Ideally, it should have a good stereoscopic visualization. The illuminating system should be such that it should evenly illuminate the entire surgical field. There should be a long working distance so that your instruments do not touch any part of the microscope and become unsterile. This microscope itself should be very stable, and it should have the possibility to adapt to a wide range of procedures, whether it is an anterior segment surgery, whether it is a posterior segment surgery, because you need to have different depths of focus for all these. Why is PG training initially necessary for this? As I already discussed, because obviously we cannot do most of the surgeries of ophthalmic surgeries without the microscope. And as an undergraduate, we are not given any training in the use of operating microscope, no experience in doing a microsurgery as well during the undergraduate period. The disadvantage of an operating microscope nowadays, unless until you have a high-end microscope, which has a projector system to it, a camera attached to it, and we are projecting onto a screen, then it's different. But otherwise, there's only one assistant who's able to observe the surgery with the main surgeon. And even if it is, unless we do use a 3D system, even if you're projecting on the screen, it would be a 2D visualization, unless you have a high-end Ingenuity system or other systems with ARPA available for 3D visualization. Then again, we do not have, as a PG, when we're joining as a PG, we do not have any hand-eye-foot coordination concept. Maybe lot of people may not be even having the bidexterity, which is required for ophthalmic surgeries. And also the binocular and depth perception analysis, which is to be done in coordination with your own optical system and the optical system of the operating microscope is also not there. You've not been trained for that. So how does training help? It helps in visualization. Obviously, you're able to see better ocular structures, better image resolution, a wider field illumination is under your control, and depth perception. Physically, also, you tend to learn how to keep your posture without causing unnecessary ergonomic strains on your posture. Correction, also, you learn to adapt to eye strain, headache, diplopes, all those things once you're being trained for microscope use in the wet labs or the dry labs or the simulated labs. And how does it further help? Is basically, obviously, as I already told, you will be able to understand a postgraduate training will be able to understand what the various parts of the microscope will help in learning his coordination for all this hand, foot, and eye coordination. It helps the postgraduate also to adapt to an OT environment and the microsurgery in a wet lab scenario. So he is able to gain a comfortable learning experience in that scenario and is able to develop his skills before he actually moves on to the actual cases in the operating room. So this gives him a sort of wipes off his fear of doing the actual surgery. Obviously, the principle of an operating microscope is based on any optics. There's all optic-based principles, and there are various terms which we use in these optics. I'll go about these terms as we discuss the various parts of the microscopes. The basic thing which you have to remember is obviously the purpose of a good ophthalmic microscope is that it should have smooth magnification without any change in the working distance. And for this smooth transit of magnification, either we can have a knob, which can give us a stepwise magnification, or we can have a zoom system, which has a foot pedal control. And the purpose is that without the change in the eye object distance, they're able to achieve a good image size on the retina for whatever surgery which we are doing. So these are basically the main parts, the optic cards, the binocular tubes, the beam splitter, the magnification changer, the objective lens, and finally the surgical field. I'll be talking about these in details. Maybe the apochromatic optic concept has to apochromatic optic concept, I'll skip this, but the parts on operating microscope are basically three: optical system, illumination system, the stand, and the suspension arm. So the optical system is basically a Is basically a consists of a binocular head, a magnification changer, and an objective lens. So this is basically the main the main surgeon's position, and this is the assistant eyepieces. I can just skip these slides because these were explaining these things in details. We can just go. So what is the next thing, which is a magnification changer, which I've already talked the bout, which can be in the form of a knock or could be foot controlled with a foot paddle. The working distance concept is that basically it is a distance between the objective lens to the point of focus at which we are working. And this is fixed depending on the type of surgery which we have taken. And the next concept, which is very important for the postgraduates to know, is a path for quality concept, which means it is a state, that state of configuration which we're able to enable magnification changes without causing change in the point of focus. So there's a video on that, probably short of time, I will not run this video, but there's a path for quality basically means that even at the high, first we bring the microscope to the highest magnification, we set it there and bring the objects in focus. Then we go to the minimum magnification and then again bring the object into focus. And at this, once this has been done, after that, we will not be able to, even while changing the magnification at any point of time during the surgery, we will not be requiring to change the gross focus. All the settings would be done by a fine focus on the foot pedal control. So depth of field and depth of focus, these are basically reversely related to the magnification. So higher the magnification, shallow will be the depth of field or the depth of focus which we get. And similar is the resolution directly related. So resolution will be the same as the, it will be better if you have a higher magnification, but the depth of focus and depth of field will go.
Ma'am, can you conclude, please?
Yeah. So the just one important thing which I would like to tell you about the illumination system, we use coaxial method of illumination. The purpose of coaxial illumination is that the light follows back the same path as the images. And this helps us in avoiding shadowing. And this is an important concept which is used in ophthalmic operating microscopes. So this is a diagram which is just showing how it works. And in this sand and suspension arm, basically to give stability to the microscope, and the foot pedal settings, basically which have a joystick, which helps in moving the, in a horizontal plane, we can make fine movements. Then the footrest, which is there, and this is all programmable. So we can have the upper rocker switch, which could be for the focus in and out, and the lower rocker switch, which could be the zoom in and out, or we can have interchangeable settings depending on the surgeon's convenience. But it is important that as a initially, what the person has to understand that he should initially, when he's starting with the surgery, he should be able to understand where to turn on the microscope. He should be able to manually bring the microscope onto the area of focus and then determine which side he has to sit on, whether temporal approach or superior approach, depending on the type of surgery which you are doing. And initially, in the beginning of the surgery, you have to first of all center your XY button, that is the zoom, that is your joystick, with the control which is there on the microscope, not through the foot pedal, because the foot pedal is for fine focus, fine changes. And similarly, focus it, as I told you, by the path focality concept in the beginning itself. So that whatever focus later on, you do not need to touch your microscope body. It is all by foot pedal controls. Check your interpupillary distance and zero the objective so that you're not either over-accommodating or also dial in your refractive errors in the eyepiece's lenses, where there is a dialing for your own refractive errors. And so this will allow you to have the maximum exertion of these functions during the case. So this is in the end, after this training, should be able to say that I know my microscope. So all these things are important for a postgraduate to start any ophthalmic surgery.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much for that wonderful presentation.